People, Deluded, I'm back again. Now, Alex Runarsson has been officially announced as an Arsenal player. We finally got a replacement for Emi Martinez. He's joined Arsenal on a four-year contract. He'll wear the number 13. And yeah, man, congratulations on your move. Well done for coming to the club. You know, we're going to support you in whatever way we see fit, whichever way we can, you know, depending on how often you play. I know a lot of reports are saying he could be involved against Leicester on Wednesday. Is that the smartest of things? I don't know, because I don't know if he's trained with the squad. I don't know, to be throwing guys in there. Should it be best Leno to play? I don't know. You know, I don't know too much about this goalie. I know when you do your research, you know, he's quite up there for saves, or it's an okay amount of saves. But there's a lot of negative stats in relation to goalies, and his name is quite there. Now, at the end of the day, I'm going to support any player that comes through these doors. Stats doesn't mean anything on the football field. And, you know, I won't say I've got too much expectations of you. All I hope is that when your time comes, and if you are required, that you're ready and you prove yourself as a competent option. You hear Naki Peña is a big reason as to why we've signed him, having previously worked with him in a coaching capacity before, you know. We've seen how important it is to have a number two. You know, Willy Caballero and Kepa are just, lesser of two evils. But imagine they had an okay option where when Kepa did eventually get dropped and that guy made his name for itself. At Arsenal, we see what Dean Henderson. De Gea's under pressure and he's got Dean Henderson at United. Specific to Arsenal, you saw last season how important it actually is to have a very good backup number two. They're very difficult to source. And granted, I know, man, I remember when we had Ospina and then Mandé, it was quite mad. And how much of a part they can play in your season. Now, granted, it happened towards the end of the campaign where we kind of knew where we were finishing, but Martinez still had some tough games, specifically the cup competitions. So I hope you can do this. You know, I believe he's 25 years of age. He's my age, so he's not the oldest. So he's got time on his hands. He signed a four-year deal. So you've got time to do yourself, really. He was at Dijon for 2 years. He joined in July 2018. Made 13 appearances across all competitions last season. Was he necessarily first choice for Dijon? I'm not too sure. He spent time in his homeland, I assume, and he's also played for a couple of other teams within his homeland. And he made 62 appearances across a three-year spell for FC Nordsjælland, can't say it, before he moved to France. I'm onto him, I'm not going to lie. One thing I'm onto him about is, and I'm sure if you dig up everyone's tweets, it's a bit mad, but he was dissing Arsene Wenger a bit mad a couple years ago. And you're wearing my favourite number. I don't really like goalies wearing it, but I'm onto you about that stuff. But on a serious note, Mikel Arteta said, "We want to create healthy competition for places and we look forward to seeing Alex bring further depth to the goalkeeping position." Edu, our technical director, said, "We're very pleased to welcome Alex to our squad. We've been monitoring him for some time, and from the analysts, he has strong attributes that we look for in a goalie and a person." So again, you know, Martinez was going to leave at one point, and we must have had scouting lists or a list of targets. He said he's been looking at him for a while. Could he have been on that list? We hear Naki Peña obviously knows about him. He obviously recommended him now. Did he recommend him away ages ago? You know, if I was to play devil's advocate, I'd say, you know, I don't think this guy was on the list. I think we're looking for number twos, and maybe the other number twos we was going for have moved elsewhere or they're difficult to obtain. And, you know, Inaki Peña on the coaching staff has opened his mouth, spoke up and verified that this is a decent keeper. Then I believe analysts came into it and saw his thing. And, you know, there's a lot of negative stats surrounding him. I don't want to put a downer on him, but, you know, once he signs, that's all that matters. We'll support him, of course, through no fault of his own. You know, when you hear Arsenal have announced a signing, you want to hear the Partey's or the Arawas or all of these names. You don't necessarily want to hear a second choice goalie. You know, it remains to be seen if we're going to move for another goalie. You know, Raya at Brentford's been linked. You know, apparently we want two. You know, Matt Macey at least will stay at least until another number two or another goalie comes in. And for him, he needs to be selfish and go and get first team football because he's nowhere near it at Arsenal. But for Arsenal, it might not make sense to let him go until there's clarity. But, you know, on the basis of getting Martinez out, he wanted to leave. You know, we've sold him for 20-odd. You've brought in a keeper for a couple of mil. At 25, if he can prove himself as a competent option when called upon, great, you know. If not, it is what it is. I don't know if the Leicester game has come too soon. But you'd imagine, depending on how we do and if we advance, that competition, the Carling Cup, Cat Yarabel is going to be where he plays. You know, the Europa League, you've got a couple of group stage fixtures there. You might even get a round in the FA Cup, depending on who we face. And, you know, Martinez has kept Leno out in terms of the Community Shield when Leno's fit. Maybe that, in hindsight, was a farewell for Martinez. But if you're fit, you know, and you earn it above Leno and there's pressure on Leno, be ready. You never know when your opportunity comes. I don't want man to come here and think, yeah, I'm 25, I've gone from Dijon, and I don't know if I've necessarily earned this move to Arsenal. But at 25, I've signed a four-year deal. I'm cool here until I'm 29. I'm living in London. I'm getting better wages than I probably was getting. You know, it is quite sweet being a number two or a third choice keeper in terms of a job. But when your time comes, I just want you to be a competent guy. We're going to have to learn these things, you know, playing out from the back's what we need to do in this team. Can you do that to an okay standard? Are you calm and collected when you're collecting crosses and things like that out of the air? Do you command your box? How's your reflexes? How's your shot stopping? You know, how's your personality? It sounds mad, but I on my own Sunday team, I have a quiet keeper, you know, a keeper that doesn't open his mouth, and I'm part of the defence. I'm not saying he's going to be like that, but this is it. I just want to see you, I don't want to say average, but if you can just be a 5, 6 out of 10, you know, when your chance comes, I'm not looking at the keeper like you're a madness. I can't really complain. So I wish him all the best. I wish him all the success. And he joins part of the squad that wants to try and move back into the top four. So I hope the mentality is there, because it's a massive thing we've got to do. And, you know, I don't know how good our personality checks are, because, yeah, to be fair, you know, people said Aubameyang had attitude issues, not had one thing bad to say since he's joined here. We heard Guendouzi was a bit reckless. Are we really confused and amazed that, you know, there's been some sort of bust up of such? You know, Torreira is a good player, but he seems to be a bit homesick and a bit of a, you know, a bit, I don't want to say it, but a bit soft off the field. You know, that's probably been difficult for him. So maybe in terms of his personality and how he is and his stature, could we have seen that he's quite shy off the field, or could we have been given any indications that he might struggle to settle in another environment and might need an environment closer towards what a South American landscape would look like? Only, you know, Arsenal can answer that in hindsight. So hearing Edu drop, we've done our research on the person. Hopefully they have and they've found anything. He's smart because he's deleted his Wenger tweets and whatnot. But welcome to the club, man. Wish you all the best. We move forward. We've got a backup goalie. We've moved in the transfer market for a centre-half. Just bring me them midfielders, and with 2 weeks to go, and we all, as Arsenal fans, shut up. But until then, we'll have to see people. People, it's always a pleasure. DG, I'm out.